Hello everyone, in this video I'm unboxing and reviewing the M106K. Gaoman did send me this tablet for a review, but all thoughts and opinions are my own, so let's get started! When we open the box, we see this card. Instead of having an installation disk, you download the software for the tablet from the Gaoman website. Next we have the tablet, but we'll get to that in a second. Here we have this cute little pouch, it's so cute. And inside we have the four replacement pen nibs and the pen nib clip to remove the nib from the pen. Next we have the pen. The pen feels very nice. It is smooth and feels very nice when I hold it. It has a cap, which is interesting. I've never had a tablet with a cap for the pen. The pen does need to be charged. On a full charge, the pen lasts for 350 hours, and it takes 2 to 3 hours to charge. The pen also doesn't have an eraser function, which may be a downside for some people. Then we have the cable for the tablet and the charging cable for the pen. Now for the tablet. It has a 10 by 6.25 inch working area. The tablet is also very thin, so it's a good size and very comfortable to use. It has 2048 levels of pressure sensitivity. One thing that makes this tablet really unique is that it has 12 customizable express keys. This is the most express keys I've ever seen on a tablet, so if you like express keys, this may be a good tablet for you. So now I'm going to discuss what I think about the M106K. While I'm doing this, you'll be watching me draw a picture that I drew using the M106K. So I usually don't mention the price of the tablet until like the end of the review, but this tablet is only $68, and in my opinion that is a really good deal for what you get. Setting up the tablet was really simple. It took me under 5 minutes, which was really nice. The tablet itself feels very nice. It doesn't feel cheap or flimsy. I really like the size of the tablet. It's a nice size to work with. It's not too big or too small. The express keys are very responsive and have a nice click when I press them. There's even a little indicator light that turns on when I press an express key. That way I know that the tablet is picking up that I'm pressing a key. I guess the only real kind of downside that some people might have is that the pen does need to be charged. For some tablets, the pen doesn't need to be charged. The pen does need to be charged in for this tablet. Thankfully, it has a very long battery life and it doesn't need to be charged for very long, only 2 to 3 hours. But some people having to charge the pen might seem kind of like a downside. And the pen doesn't have an eraser function, which can also seem like a downside to some people. I never really use the eraser on my pen. I occasionally use it, but not very often. So for me, this isn't that big of a deal, but it might be a big deal to some people, so I am mentioning it. So the tablet does only have 2048 levels of pressure sensitivity. More expensive tablets usually have around 8,000. I can tell the difference. I feel like I have to press a little harder than usual with this tablet, but it is a pretty small difference. Like, if I had never used a tablet before, I probably wouldn't really know the difference. It's just that I've used a lot of tablets, so I'm starting to become good at telling the difference between them. The tablet still performs very well though. I was still able to easily make thinner or thicker lines depending on how much pressure I put on the pen. So it's still very workable and usable, and it worked very well. While I was drawing with the tablet, I thought it was very easy to use. It felt responsive and I didn't have any major issues while working with it. Like I mentioned, this tablet is only $68, so I think this is a very good tablet if you want to get into digital art but not have to spend a ton of money. So yeah, I feel like this tablet is really good if you want to get started in digital art for a good price. I enjoyed using it and I think it's a good tablet. Well, that is all I have to say. I hope you enjoyed this video. Also, this is a bonus video, so I'll be back on Saturday with my usual weekly video. So I'll see you all then. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you on Saturday. Bye!